7,21,000 per year in India and $108,000 in USA is the average salary of a data analyst, which requires almost zero or basic understanding of coding. In this video, I'm going to share in detail roadmap with the free resources that I have personally followed to become a data analyst, which will help you to become a job ready. I have given the link of this roadmap into my description, so please feel free to check it out. Before we move forward, I would like to share that the roadmap I have created is on the basic assumption that you are completely novice or the beginner in this coding field. And if you have a basic understanding of coding, I'll share how you can complete this 3-month roadmap in just 3 weeks. And hence, please watch this video till end to know more. So if you're new in the channel, hi, my name is Omkar. I am currently working as a data engineer with almost having 3 years of experience. I have also worked my first job as a data analyst, business analyst. Who cares? Please do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. This will bring new content like this onto your feed for free. For free, right? Yeah, I guess so. Now let's get ahead and discuss the complete roadmap. In the first month, we'll be mastering the basic tools and the concepts, in which the first week will be the basic understanding of the role of a data analyst. You will get to know about data analyst on the topics of understanding what a data analyst does. And you can also learn about the difference between data analytics and the business intelligence. The resources you would use, you can go in the LinkedIn. And here we are at the one job description by the company called An Academy. Here in the responsibility, you can see words like KPI, analytics, you can see analyze, you can see stakeholders, and you can see databases. In the preferred skill in the qualification, you can see ETL, you can see model design and segmentation technique, you can see statistics. Now, all these terms and keywords that we have seen in job description are related to data analyst field. Now, after you have overview, on the week 2, we'll get to know about Excel. The goal here is to learn fundamental of Excel, the most common tool for data analyst. There are many tools for data analyst, but Excel is the basic foundation tool and most of the companies still uses Excel as the data analyst tool. The topics here you can cover is introduction to Excel, using functions like sum, average, if, VLOOKUP. You can learn about the basic data cleaning like removing duplicates, text to columns and handling the missing data. The task you have to perform after learning these topics is perform a basis analysis on the dataset. I have given the link of the dataset here in the practice dataset, so you can check it out, the dataset. The resources you can use here is an Excel training. It is given by official team of Microsoft Excel. In the week 3, we would perform data cleaning and formatting in Excel, which is an advanced level of learning than the week 2. The goal here is to master clean data to prepare it for a data analysis. Topics here is to cover is sorting and filtering data using pivots, conditional formatting, data validation techniques. Task here is to clean a raw data set and create a summary report. You can use same data set. The link I have given is already here. So you can check it out and do summarize report and perform this task. There is one blog called Data Cleaning in Excel, which gives 30 plus useful techniques for the data cleaning. In the week 4, we would learn about the descriptive statistics. You can learn the topics like mean, median, mode, variance, and deviation. You can create histograms and bar charts, correlation and covariance. The task here is to calculate and interpret descriptive statistics for a dataset. The question you'll ask me that how or where you can complete this task. You can use Python and on the Jupyter notebook, you can able to complete this task. I will discuss what is Python and Jupyter in the next section. So please bear with me. The resources you can use for statistics is Edureka. In the month 2, we would start with the SQL, Python and data visualization. In the week 5, Introduction to SQL for data analysis. This is a basic one. The goal here is to learn how to extract data from the databases. That means, in short, we are reading the database. We are not putting or creating or any inserting the data. We are just reading or extracting the data from the database. The topic here is you can cover is, of course, select statement, where, join, group by, order by. You can also learn about introduction to database management. The task here is to write the simple SQL queries to extract insight from the sample dataset. The resources you can use is W3 Schools. This is a text-based tutorial. I'm one of the best and I have followed and I'm still following this resource as to revise my concept of SQL. This is one of the best text-based tutorial I have seen. You can complete your SQL task on this SQL playground. In the week 6, you can learn about advanced SQL queries. You'll write some complex queries for data extraction. The topic here is subqueries, window functions like maybe partition by. You can learn about aggregate functions like count, sum, average. You will also be able to write joins. Joins is one of the favorite questions of every interviewer. And more time you spend on these joins, more will be beneficial for you. And also, if time permits, if you can learn about the CTE, which is common table expression. The task here is you can write SQL queries involving complex joins and aggregation. You can either do it yourself, or you can solve the problems given in practice SQL or given in the lit code. In the week 7, we'll cover Python basics for data analysis. The topic we can cover is basic Python syntax like variable, data types, loops, conditions. Then we'll learn about what is pandas and numpy, the libraries. We'll also learn about how we can load and manipulate data set in the Python. The task here is to use Python to load CSV and perform data cleaning, maybe using data frame, or you can just have the table and you can do it on level. The resources you can use here is course that given by the data camp. The length of this course is 4 hours, and you can practice or you can write the code on the Jupyter notebook. And also you can perform the statistical task which we have discussed earlier on the Jupyter notebook. You can click on this link, or you can have your separate IDE like VS Code or PyCharm. In the week 8, we'll start with the data visualization with Python. We will learn about how to create meaningful visualization with Python. Topics here to cover are Matplotlib, Seaborn, and learn about line chart, bar chart, pie chart, and histograms. Then you will learn about other customizing graphs, maybe using labels, titles, legends. All these you can perform on Python on using Jupyter. The resources you can use to study this is there is a course video-based tutorial on a Coursera called Data Visualization with Python. The course, which is a text-based tutorial, is Introduction to Data Visualization in Python. You can also practice dataset on given in the Kaggle. In the month 3, we will start building our projects and hence building our portfolio. In the week 9, we will start with the EDA, which is Exploratory Data Analysis. In this, we will gain insights from the data. The topics here is handling missing data, detecting outliers, understanding distributions. You can perform EDA on dataset, write a summary report. The course here is text-based called Exploratory Data Analysis given by DataCamp. In the week 10, we'll start the data creation. Power BI is one of the most favorite dashboard creation tool and widely used in the area of data analyst. But in the few of the companies, Tableau is preferred. But if you ask me, please first go with the Power BI. And if time permits, you can go Tableau. The task here is to create a simple interactive dashboard from the dataset. The Power BI course and the Tableau course given by their official website. In the week 11 and 12, we will understand the business analytics and building a data analytics portfolio. Goal here is to apply all skill learned by till now in the building project for our portfolio. The topics here is you can understand business matrices like KPIs, financial ratio, customer acquisition cost, and etc. if any business term they have given in the problem, of course. And the data storytelling, how to present data insight to the stakeholder. And this is one of the most important thing that most of the professions still don't have. They might know about coding, they might know about how to create a dashboard in Power BI, Tableau. They don't know how they can present the data insights they have gathered to their stakeholders. This is one of the most important skills. The project here is you can do one project or if time permits two. The first project is to analyze the sales data and provide insight on the growth opportunities, or you can do is create a Power BI dashboards which utilizes business KPIs. And we are at the final step, and which is the most important one, that the job search and the certifications. And having certifications is good, but it is not must. And if you want to get the solid understanding of our topics, then please go to the certification. And hence, it is not mandatory to be certified, but it's good to have. Certifications you can consider is Microsoft Certified Data Analyst Associate for Power BI users, or you can get the Tableau Desktop Specialist. Now to search the job for the data analyst, you can create a LinkedIn profile or the Naukri profile that highlights your new skills. You can include your portfolio of projects. You can say that I have created dashboards using Power BI and Tableau, or you can give the link of your dashboard into your resume. You can practice interview questions related to SQL, data visualization, and business analytics. And hence, to get more gauge on the field of data analyst. If time permits, you can read these two books called Python for Data Analysis and SQL for Data Analysis. Now let's get ahead and understand how you can complete this 3-month journey in just 3 weeks if you have a basic understanding. They might not have the knowledge of statistics and they can spend 3 days over here. In the month 2, they might have know about SQL, Python, data visualization, but still they need to practice it. So let's go ahead and give this as a 1 week, because practicing SQL and Python is very important, and I'm giving generous amount of time here. So 1 week and earlier we spent 3 days. Now we have 1 week and 4 days more. So that they can spend over here 1 week and 4 days. 1 week plus 4 days. Here, they'll first start with a dashboard creation because most of the coding guys don't know about dashboard creation and hence they'll acquire knowledge of Power BI or the Tableau. Hope this video was helpful for you. And if you want me to cover some other roadmaps, do comment roadmap. Please do give video thumbs up and share this with your friends so that this video will get a wider reach. And also subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. This will bring new content like this onto your feed. Thanks for watching this video till end. See you in the next video. Bye.